able to hear my voice though.
Yeah, I don't.
No.
I don't. Well, are you muted?
I am, but that's not like you still won't be able to hear it, so. Which is like whatever. It's not the worst thing. 5 seconds
remaining. Well, not the biggest deal. I can always hear you like this.
Yes. I can hear you pretty well too, you're fine.
I've worked in worse setups before, so Radiant team ban. This is fine.
This is definitely fine. Alright, I'm gonna go here in a second.
Is this mine? I can't remember.
Yeah, probably it is.
Yeah, yes. 10 seconds
remaining. Alright, here we go. Hello everybody and welcome back to the Manila Major Group Stages. We are here with our last series of Group A, Team Empire versus OG Dota 2. That is right, ladies and gentlemen. The winner of this series will move up to the upper bracket and play in those best of threes. Loser of this series gets put into the first round of the lower bracket into a best of one series. Pretty big deal. These two teams have already squared off, both Empire and OG, going toe-to-toe in the first series of the day. Now they are here in the last series. OG getting the better of them in the first series, OG going down to newbie, Empire beating Complexity, and here we are. My name is Mont. With me today is Winter. How do you feel about the series, man?
Hey, OG looked pretty good in the first series when they actually when they beat Empire, and you know, and overall, but then they got crushed by newbie after a very strong newbie.
Yes, and I think a lot of people were talking about, okay, newbie seems really good, but just how good are they? But then you watch the games, you look at the replays, you look at what happened in that series. It just seemed like newbie, number one, the drafts were way better for them, I think, in most situations. And number two, they just outclassed them in team fighting and rotations and movement, tempo controlling, which is what you brought up earlier. So I think it was just a very solid draft from newbie coming out, and very solid gameplay too.
Like when I watch Dota now, I understand two things that are extremely important: tempo plus scaling. You need to have a all-rounded lineup, like heroes that scale very well into the late game, because it's very difficult to finish games early nowadays because of how the game has changed over the patch. High ground defense, games getting longer, makes teams tend to draft more late game. But at the same time, you cannot ignore the early game. Previous patch was a lot of focus on the early game, because the early game heroes, the Chen and Chandra's, are all very, very powerful. But this patch is a bit nerfed, the jungle, so those heroes are not as strong, but it's still important. That's why you still see games where Doom, when you have a roaming hero like Doom, Bounty, Earth Spirit, all these heroes are very strong at controlling the early game.
Yeah, and there is an Earth Spirit in this game, and it is a crit Earth Spirit, which is very, very strong.
Yeah.
And obviously one of his best heroes, if not his best hero, I think, overall, currently in Dota. So
I like their response too, because they want to take away the Dark Seer plus Earth Spirit duo, which is very, very strong. Because every time I see Earth Spirit, Dark Seers, they just wreck the lane so hard. And it's very, very powerful in the sense that the early game becomes very, very dangerous because of the Iron Shell. And the supports can't really, you know, you can't really harass the Dark Seer when you don't see the Earth Spirit on the map, because you're just worried that he might be just sitting down, because most of the time you don't see the Earth Spirit.
Earth Spirit, very dangerous hero. I do like what Empire have done, though. A lot of people talk about how Darkseer is very good against Lifestealer. Obviously, with Surge, Iron Shell, and Lane is pretty strong. So, Team Empire, they get the Darkseer out of the way first. And then OG, they don't, obviously, they get the Earth Spirit, but the Lifestealer goes the way of Empire. So, they have that
block pick.
Something. Exactly.
It's like the other hero that I think Miracle has been playing a lot recently. I noticed that he's been utilizing the hero. They've been picking a lot of Lifestealer for him.
Yes.
For maybe, I think the biggest reason is the pool of heroes that are coming into play recently are more strength heavy. A lot of HP means Lifestealer benefits a lot from attacking those heroes with Feast. And obviously the hero got a good buff when they buff Armlet. And some of the new items which are pretty useful for him, like Blightstone.
Echo Saber, kind of, to a certain extent.
Yeah, Echo Saber as well, but I actually like to talk about the Blightstone more.
Yeah.
I think Blightstone is really good on Lifestealer, but I don't see players have that item on Lifestealer every time they play it.
You think it should be every game they should have Blightstone right from the get-go?
It's just so good.
It does seem very good.
Yeah.
I can see that. Another hero that Miracle has been playing a ton of is, in fact, the Juggernaut. They've been putting him in the safe lane with it. No-Tail, which is something we were just talking about, more of a space creation type of mid. Not necessarily like a puck or anything, but kind of, and David LD was talking about this earlier. He was taking more of like a 2.5 to 3 role is what he was talking about.
He's like more of the utility. He's like the offlane, the utility.
Right, exactly.
Player. He's not exactly like the position 2 hero in this team, because mostly they have two two utility players, which I would say Moon and No-Tail. They both play very similar. They don't take so much farm. But some games, I would say Moon takes a lot more farm than No-Tail, even though No-Tail is the second position player.
Yeah.
And Miracle takes the entire map. He's just like the king, you know, everything goes to him. And the other players just move around and just constantly look for kills, make space, push towers.
It kind of reminds me of old, like, maybe not old EG, but Sumail on EG or RTZ on whatever team that he's playing, or at least that, you know, it used to be like that to a certain extent. That's how it is with Miracle.
They are the only, like, strong team right now that actually does this playstyle. The other teams are more different in the sense that they play either they have a tempo control, and they have two. The common one is one tempo control, and you have two farming heroes, two farming cores.
Yeah.
Like a Kling's. Easy example to understand is Kling safe lane, and maybe you have a mid Shadow Fiend or mid Wind Ranger. You have two heroes that can be classified as a semi carry.
Okay.
Those are, or even a Dragon Knight, which is very common as well. So those are the more common playstyles. And OG is one of the teams that don't really utilize that playstyle a lot. They are the team that goes for the old traditional 4 protect 1.
Yeah, it seems to work out, but the last series, maybe not so much, going up against Newbie. It was a bit rough for them, obviously, and really just, it's a credit to Newbie. We talked about it already, but I do like Empire's Draft right now. I like the DK, I like the Lifestealer, very tanky cores. There's no Phoenix, so Sunray's not an issue, so there are other heroes that can deal with tanky strength heroes, but I don't know. I'm interested, there's a couple of bans that are kind of missing. Alchemist is pretty common. I think, I'm not maybe sure for OG, not as much, and I don't know about against a DK.
Have you seen a bounty hunter today?
No, dude, I haven't seen any bounties at all.
From the games that I was watching, I didn't catch all the games, but I don't recall seeing any bounty hunter today.
This is gonna sound crazy and dumb, but I kind of hope Riki becomes more popular than bounty. He's like really, I think he's strong in
similar,
pubs.
Similar role, maybe.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, bounty is, I'm surprised he's not gotten touched. I don't think I've watched most of the games today that I can, except for when I was casting. I couldn't watch all the Wings DC
That's
games.
That's like an NA Dota thing. Ricky.
Bounty?
Oh, no,
Ricky. Yeah. Because I was talking to Fogged about it too. He was talking about how it was in his pubs all the time and how it just like frustrates the hell out of him. Because like once you get, if you do get a Diffusal Blade on Ricky, then you're owning people generally because they're silenced up. There's nothing you could do. But
I mean, even though Ricky is like a hero that has been utilized a lot from only the NA teams, I think Complexity use it a lot against Enigma. Zefik plays it very well. And the other team that I saw use it was probably EG.
I think it was EG.
Yeah, only those teams from NA, I think, regularly play the hero. And if you think about the way Ricky is played, it's very similar to Earthspirit, Doom, Bounty Hunter, where you want one hero running around early game, pressuring, control runes, scouting, whatever. So that is a hero that fits that criteria.
Yeah.
He's just a bit underwhelming if you compare him to Earthspirit, especially Earthspirit, because Earthspirit just does everything that you do better.
Exactly.
You silence, you disable, you have AoE.
Yeah, you don't have a disable on Ricky. See, you have the smoke cloud and that's great, but you don't have that disable that the Earthspirit has.
But you have permanent invisibility. That's
true.
What you have.
That's the trade-off.
But I wouldn't say that's better than Earthspirit.
Yeah. Earthspirit is, I mean, he's first pick for a reason, ladies and gentlemen. This is a very good hero. Empire has been running Disruptor a lot. They picked it first two, I think, in the last series against Complexity, I'm pretty sure is what they did.
It's a very strong support now. I see supports that are very common, Lion and Disruptor. These two are like the top two supports for lane support, like in the safe lane. Disruptor and Lion, those are the supports that does a lot and provide a lot for a team. Lion is more single target pickoff. Disruptor is team fight. And against certain heroes like Slark, it's much better to have a Disruptor. In this game, the Disruptor pick doesn't really like counter any of the heroes on the opposing team. It's more of they just want a very good support that can have a spell that synergizes with Vacuum. Because right now, Lifestealer and DK don't really synergize well with Vacuum, apart from the Iron Shell, which is good for the early game. So they are looking for a support that can have a combination spell, which is the silence from Disruptor when you have the Vacuum.
The wombo combo, if you will, coming out from Team Empire with Disruptor as well as Darkseer. So yeah, and on top of that, two Breathe Fire 2 is not a bad AoE. Oh, and Infest as well. So there's a couple of good AoE abilities from Empire to clean up or to get things going for them.
Yeah, talking about Infest, they do lack a common vehicle.
Yes.
Yeah. I mean, DK can be the vehicle if you have a Blink. So if you itemize differently.
Shadowblade maybe too. Yeah, that's I was looking at that. I was like, well, you have a Darkseer, you have a Lifestealer and a DK, but that's not that good. So maybe they pick something. Mm-hmm. What do they need here? So they have a safe laner, they have an off laner, they have a mid laner, they need another support. I think Earthspirit would have been nice, but there's no way you get that fifth any game, so, and it's already picked
for
up.
For Empire,
obviously,
they need like a tempo point early game because they have very good like control in the game and they have levels on Darkseer, Lifesteal. They don't need too many items because Iron Shell onto a Lifestealer with Amulet is extremely potent. So that's one thing good for their game. They don't really need to wait too long before they can fight. But their early game will be very disruptive against the Earth Spirit because right now OG has a hero that can disrupt your laning phase, which is really, really important. Because right now, when they go into the mid game against the Iron Shell, it's very dangerous against that.
Yeah, Iron Shell is going to be
Iron Shell Lifestealer DK is very, very scary.
Yeah, very strong. Put it on both of them, you run it, you get run at, and then all of a sudden you're just dead. Mm. You drop from pretty much 100 to nothing instantly. We didn't talk about the Alchemist pick and the Dazzle pick for OG. Dazzle's been being picked up a bit more commonly. I've seen Wings do it a lot. They used to like to pair it with Huskar, but they've just picked it up kind of all together. They pick it up whenever they can with Dazzle, so Dazzle seems like a good choice. They pair it up with the Earth Spirit, so you have an aggressive hero, you have somebody that's a bit more defensive with Dazzle, but can pump out damage with the Shadow Wave. He's obviously a good laning hero, so I think it's a smart choice for OG.
So they need a Moon hero right now.
Wow.
Light Stalker.
That's not shocking. He's played this hero before.
I was actually thinking of Centaur more, because Centaur is pretty good versus the open wounds. But overall, Night Stalker will provide something else different, which is the vision control, which you see a lot of teams starting to prioritize more. When you don't have Beastmaster, you have Night Stalker. These are the two premier heroes that provide a lot of vision for our team.
You know what I'm worried about is I feel like Night Stalker against tankier cores like Darkseer, Lifestealer, and DK, like how he's going to kill people like when he's like when you roam around at nighttime, one of the first couple of night times, he's not going to be able to do any damage to Ramses or the DK. So I feel like that's kind of a big issue. You're missing a little bit of damage early on in the game is kind of what I'm concerned about for OG.
I think that Night Stalker, because they didn't have many good options as well, because a Bad Rider was banned, like Tide was banned. They don't have all the standard offlane go-to options available. So that's why I was thinking Centaur, and Night Stalker was also the remaining options available. Maybe they felt like they wanted to have much better mid-game, so with the Aghanims, Night Stalker, you have a much better mid-game compared to the Centaur, because with the vision. So we'll see how they run it. I guess Iron Talon jungling, like what we've been seeing a lot in most of the games, the offlane just jungles. And I like Empire's approach, because if you remember the last game where OG lost to Newbie, Newbie did the greedy. I was talking to you about when OG picked their supports that can't pressure the early game.
The Beastmaster.
Newbie just opted to use Beastmaster jungle because they know that they can get away. And I like the Empire approach this game where they understand that it's difficult for OG to pressure too much early except from the Earth Spirit. And they feel like they might be able to run the same strategy that was successful where Newbie was successful in the second game where they did the Beastmaster jungle.
Yeah. This time they're going to trade the Beastmaster for the Enigma, however. He will deny the creep mid more than likely, and we'll get underway here. Again, remember, guys, that this is a best of three series that will determine who moves up to the upper bracket and who goes down to the lower bracket. OG, the obvious favorites in this series. Looking at the draft objectively, Winter, do you have a favorite in this particular game one way or the other?
Before then, I know I mentioned the jungling hero when Yubi ran, which was successful, but this game is against Earth Spirit. I'm not sure whether it can be as successful again, but before that, I was favoring Empire a lot. Now, I think I might favor OG right now. Okay. After that last pick, I think OG's heroes are much easier to execute.
Are we going to see a brawl at the top rune spot? Looks like Empire is going to back away. They do have the Iron Shell on Scandal, which we've talked about already, but they give the Bounty Rune away to No-Tail. He gets up the Grievous Greed, and they're going to go back to work. He's got 400 gold right now. The mid-matchup, it's going to be him going up against Scandal on the DK.
Oh no, he made a mistake. He didn't deny the creep. He was talking to his team, or he was looking at the rune, and he missed the timing to actually deny the creep. Oh.
He can still do it now, but it's going to be a little bit late,
I feel like. This is a big deal. This is a big mistake.
This is going to put Miposhka's timings off. This is not great.
This is really, really bad. Oh my god.
He even takes some damage on the Eidolons, which is not great. The creeps do spawn, so it might not hurt him that badly, but it's still not going to be the best start coming out for the Enigma, for sure.
Interesting lanes by OG, though. They're leaving the Juggernaut alone against Darkseer, and they're opting to have a dual lane because Enigma jungle, so there's only two heroes on the safe lane. So they are choosing to pressure and limit the Lifesteal's farm in the lane.
Oh my god, is Afterlife going for this kill? Iron Shell? No Blade Fury left? Can he actually just right click him down? If the Salve comes down, he needs a right click to stop it, but now Afterlife is actually in trouble. We'll take a couple of tower hits, and Miracle, he just needs one more right click, but Afterlife is a little bit too speedy. Miracle's move speed not quite, and it is actually further than Afterlife's, but still, he will get away. Afterlife will Salve up, and that's gonna be that.
Holy shit, that was such a good play for Miracle. You can do that versus the level 1 Iron Shell.
Yes. And it was around the tree line too, so he wasn't going to get punched. He was going to use his fog to his advantage. That was I was very worried for Miracle
that,
for a second.
That move actually just solidified the fact that he's one of the best, I think he's if not the best individual skilled player in the world.
Not 9k MMR for nothing, Winter, and that guy is damn good.
So right now the Earth Spirit is just trying to make life difficult for Miposhka. Trying to steal his experience, he even plays a ward, so he's gonna be able to scout him out and know his positioning all the time.
This is just like solid standard Earth Spirit play. I've seen Soxa do this all the time when there's an enemy jungler. He just is aggressive. He's done this, I think, exact same thing DC have against Complexity, where there's an Enigma and Kurt was taking camps away. So and it's sort of similar to what kind of an Elder Titan does from time to time with Soxa, but it is better for the Earth Spirit for sure. Or excuse me, for the Earth Spirit for sure, just to leech this experience, be a nuisance to Miposhka, and so he can't get anything done.
This is like good enough. Like Earth Spirit needs this crucial level 2. Like it's like Tuss. When you get level 2, the hero becomes much more useful when you're roaming around. So the more I see this, the more I think that the Enigma jungling against the Earth Spirit might not be actually that good.
Yeah, you were questioning it earlier. You're certainly not sold on it now. Miposhka is sitting currently at level 2, not getting the most experience because it's been leeched. And on top of that, they wasted a sentry. There's two observer wards, one over the rune spot and one, of course, deeper into the jungle. So they have good vision on top of this, which is what you talked about already with crit. Top lane, though, looks like there might be some action. Fly did get open wounded, but Moon was there to back him up, and so Ramzes can't go for the kill. And no Blightstone for Ramzes, but he has the Windlace, interestingly enough.
Windlace?
Yes. Huh.
Did he start with the Windlace? Because you can't buy it from the side shop anymore.
I think he did.
Okay, I didn't pay attention to that. That's very interesting.
Does that like signal that he goes to drum, or is that just like a casual Windlace?
I mean, even as a casual item, it's really good, in my opinion. But drums on Lifesteal is also a very good selection.
Yeah.
Not as good as before, but it's still pretty good.
Yeah, I mean, there's other options you can go for, but it's not like drums a bad option anymore.
It's not the standard go-to option that you get every game.
It used to be that. Yeah. The phase, what, phase drum?
Yep,
that build drums, a long time ago.
That was like phase drums, SMY.
Yeah.
Deso.
It's a bit different.
But right now, basically the 2 points of tempo right now, important for both teams, is on OG is obviously the Earth Spirit in the early game. He's gonna roll in.
Crit, he gets the rage off in time. They avoid the boulder smash, kinetic field not there. Shadow Wave coming out, not gonna do enough. Moon can't get there. He has no mana for the void either. Good Glimpse back. King'R will avoid the void. It's a tongue twister, and he'll be able to make it out alive. So both of them, they get pressured. Ramzes has to go all the way back home. He'll have to TP back in. He's going to miss a lot of CS here. That is a great play. Even if they rotate 3 heroes to do it for OG, that's still fantastic for them.
And Noteo's going to get the haste rune at bottom, and he's going to continue farming mid. Dragonite got the bounty rune top. And if you look at the laning phase, Alchemist is slightly behind, but it's okay for him. And Darkseer Juggernaut is 50-50, and Lifestealer is the one that suffers the most on Empire. Mm-hmm. He's getting pressured a lot. So I think, in that sense, I think OG are pretty happy with their laning phase, and now it's the first night kicking in.
Can you imagine how different this game would be if that first blood went for Afterlife down bottom against the Jug?
That would actually be really bad for OG.
Luckily, Miracles got
it might even force like a rotation that they might have to help the Juggernaut. So with that avoided, they are okay with continuously pressuring the Lifestealer at top. And this is what happens. The Lifestealer is really far behind.
Yeah, he's 4 now. He has only 13 last hits. Moon is now ahead of him. Yeah,
even though like Nightstalker isn't that far ahead of him, he's like only 4 CS ahead. But Nightstalker doesn't need as much farm as Lifestealer. So that's a really good trade for OG.
Oh, bottom lane, they get the kill. It looks like Miracle got his Omni Slash off. God, T-Tors, I can't believe it. But he gets the kill solo onto Afterlife. I should have noticed the health going down. Miracle gets the job done. And that's going to give him some decent farm too. I think he has something flying out of the courier as well. It is a full Aquila for Miracle. Nicely done there. Good stuff. Dire's bottom tower. So it's just an Omni, I think maybe a Blade Fury on top of it, but I'm not sure if he used it.
Probably just an Omni, because when I clicked over, he used his Soul Ring on Darkseer. He just recently used his Soul Ring.
Oh.
So that might have actually been the cause of Miracle going aggressive on him.
Maybe not, taking into the account that Miracle was level 6. When you're playing against a solo Jug, that experience comes quicker, so maybe you don't see it coming as quickly for Afterlife.
And you might be like a bit upset about the earlier gank that didn't happen. Ramzes top.
Yeah,
he's getting dived.
Yeah, he will get the glimpse back out from his friend, but Moon, he knows exactly where Ramzes is. They're going to ping him. The Void comes out. One more right click. Kinetic Field will not save his life. There's no glimpse. They just used it. And so finally, it's going to be another kill going OG's way.
Yeah, this Enigma jungling has hurt their laning phase a lot, especially the Lifestealer's early game progression. So he has to be able to get his level 6 ASAP and then make a play. to help his team recover, especially the life stealers game. If there's no help coming to top, the life stealers is gonna have a very, very tough game.
I feel like Beastmaster, as a hero that jungles, rotates better earlier on than Enigma does. Like, Enigma's not going to rotate, but, like, Beastmaster, with two boars and boots, you're good. But Poshka's going to get caught out. Crit's going to come in. Malphus is going to stun him. He actually might be able to stay alive, although the Orb of Venom's slowing him down. Crit, he's got a Boulder Smash in 16, Rolling Boulder in 7. Actually, Ramsey's going to come in. Can he deny himself? Absolutely not. And Poshka turns what was almost going to be a disaster into a sure benefit for himself, and that helps him a lot.
Wait, isn't it better that he uses the rock to kick him? To stun him? Because when he kicked him away, he couldn't get the last right click off.
Yeah.
I'm not sure. I'm not an Earth Spirit player, but it seemed weird that he didn't choose to use the rock. He instead uses his kick onto Poshka.
Yeah. That is kind of interesting, but...
So here comes Moon. Couldn't get the job done.
Can they get him this time? Can they kill him this time? Kinetic Field? No. They need another Void. It's 3 seconds. He's going to sit under the tower. And Ramses is back again. He's like, sure, I'll take another free kill. Open Wounds comes out. I don't know if they can kill Moon. He's rather tanky. That's what I was talking about with the Lifestealer, but it's actually the Night Stalker that's very tanky. But he limps back, and it's all the way back. They don't even get the Kinetic Field. Malphus is set up. It doesn't have mana for it. He does now, and Moon is going to escape towards the top tier 2 tower. No TP, however. They might spend a lot of time looking for him. And he's going to get spotted up. Perhaps no. They finally might get vision. It's nighttime. They have nothing. They can't see him anywhere. He's going to head back up to the high ground. He wants to go up to Poshka again. Gets for the Void. He's like, wait, he's too much. He's got too much HP. I have to head out. And so Nightstalker with a phase is able to just fly on through the jungle and stay alive when it's all said and done. Dear God, how did that happen?
Moon. I was going to say Moonlace, but it's Windlace. He had the Windlace plus phase boost. That's why he was actually he was able to actually run out of that sticky situation.
So speedy.
So you get that item as a casual slot. If you don't have like you don't get branches anymore nowadays. You either fit your slots with
Blightstone,
Windlace, or Blightstone.
Yeah, maybe Orb of Venom potentially, depending on the hero.
Either one of those. You don't actually have branches. Like it's a very old thing that you have branches, but there are things better than branches nowadays.
Moon is gonna get Malphus. Is he gonna go for this kill a third time and not be successful? He's still he's so damn fast. He's a haste rune this time. It's not even nighttime when he doesn't give a damn. He's still going to work and trying to get this kill onto Poshka. Can't get it done though.
He's making so much space for the Jug and Alchemist to farm, and this is really, really good for OG.
Yeah, look at the Alk CS now. Like Alk was he was doing okay. No Tail was doing fine, but he's up at the top in CS currently. I think he's top in the net worth. He should be. He has his full armlet now. He's got 1,300 gold. So No Tail is starting to get to that place where if you're playing against an Alchemist, it becomes very difficult and you never want to get to that place, but...
Yeah, if the game goes like even or like Empire is not gaining any advantage against the Alchemist on Juggernaut, it's going to get real tough for them. So they have to be able to do something with... Now they are waiting for the Enigma again to make his first move with the first Black Hole. This is very, very important that they at least get a very key kill, either the Alchemist or the Juggernaut with this Black Hole.
He doesn't have the mana for it right now. He has a Soul Ring ready to go, but there's no smoke coming just yet. Kingar has one currently on him. They're going to pop it, and they're going to go for a kill. Level 6 is up. It's actually level 8 for Scandal. So they have the Elder Dragon form. There's two top for OG. They're going to back together. They're looking to put pressure onto Ramses. There's the Poison Touch. The Void comes out. He does have Rage and Fest if needed, and they're going to wrap through the river. Here's the Smoke of Deceit. Gank and Fest comes through. They want damage. They didn't get it from the Infest, but the Dragon Tail comes out. He's got Grave. Can he get it off in time? No, the Malphus, the stuns were they were used perfectly, not stacked whatsoever. Moon is still going to be able to hightail it out with the phase Windlace.
That's why you get Windlace.
Oh, he's going to be able to get Glimpse back. Are you kidding? Was it level 3 or 4? Doesn't matter. He's still going to get caught.
Oh, my God.
Doing some damage to King R. He's going to get body blocked beautifully. Ravy's going to come through. He's got Open Wounds up, but not enough mana to use it. Moon's going to stick up and stay alive. The Malphus will bring him down. Two dead. And Lifestealer gets himself another kill.
He didn't expect that to be Vision. There was a wall on the cliff there for Empire. That was what gave Vision for them to get the glimpse of. Man, that Windlace almost actually saved his life again.
That was level 2 glimpse. That was like the longest range glimpse too, man. Are you joking?
Like he actually could have just ran straight if he ran this direction. If he thought that he might actually still get glimpse, but he was pretty sure he was fine. That's why he turned down the
river. Yeah, he turned the corner. Yeah.
And then he got glimpse. That really, really absolutely sucks for him, but a kill is a kill. So Empire, like I mentioned, with the first rotation of Enigma, they got 2 kills, which I mentioned before they needed to help the Lifestealer. Even though I talked about how important it is to kill either the Jug or the Alchemist, but in the end they decided that they needed to help their Lifestealer, which had a really, really tough early game.
Well, the problem right now for Empire, even though they've gotten a couple of good kills recently, is just The Alk is kind of farming out of control. Yeah, Miracle's getting so much space too, and he's going Battle Fury.
OG
as well.
Is like happy about this as long as the Alk and the Jug is continuously farming.
Scandal is going to get caught, but they used to be magnetized. No stun coming out. Finally, Will. There's the silence up as well. No armlet. Still very tanky. Shadow Wave doing some damage. Good armor though, and he's going to stick up Breathe Fire to make sure that damage reduction is there, and Scandal will be able to get under his tier 1 tower safely. But while this is all happening, Miracle gets a free tier 1 bottom with no contention whatsoever from the OG, or excuse me, the Empire squad. So they get something out of nothing essentially there.
And he's rushing the Battle Fury as well. He's not going for all mid lane. Fly gets stunned up.
Yeah, they get another boulder smash off. She's gonna go on to King R. They had a silence up as well, so Scandal couldn't quite get that kill, and King R of course as well. So Ramsey's gonna farm top. Moon's gonna get pressured. They're looking for, he's just gonna dive behind the tower. Radiant's top tower is under attack. Well, he's gonna continue to farm, get some CS as well. But there's a smoke, not even a smoke gank, there's just a gank coming in, although Crit does have the smoke ready to go. And now the Rage has to come out, he's gonna try to TP. I don't know if they can get this, they can't, the Shadow Wave damage is not enough. And so Ramsey's being a bit aggressive, doesn't necessarily pay off, but he finds some extra farm under the tower and he's good to go.
Yep, and like I mentioned before, as long as the Juggernaut and Alchemist is not getting killed, like OG is really, really happy about that. And Miracle even went for the greedier build, which is rushing the Battle Fury. Like recently, we've been seeing a lot of Juggernauts which actually go for the Vanguard first.
Mm-hmm.
So you can actually help and it's harder to gank you. But he's going for the much greedier build, so it puts a lot more pressure on Empire when you see this. Like, he's going to get his Battle Fury, they have an Alchemist farming. You're going to feel a lot of stress that you need to get something done.
And that's why they smoked up. They feel that stress, they feel that pressure, they know they need to do something. Killing Miracle would be nice. Miracle knows they're off the map. He has a good understanding that something's happening. They will rotate towards mid as they see that Miracle's not pushing up and farming any further. The Alk would be a great pick for them if they could find it. He's got Chemical Rage, he's gonna pop it, he's got his armlet ready to go as well. This is gonna be very difficult for them to get this kill. They're all gonna TP top except for No Tail. They smoke themselves up for OG. King R is gonna see No Tail walk through this ward. Can he glimpse him back? Do they wanna go for this? He's gonna decide not to. Instead, they're gonna back up and they're gonna leave Ramses alone top, who might get ganked with the Smoke of Deceit. Moon's gonna be up here in front, tanking things up and making sure he's gonna be the bodyguard, but
I was surprised they didn't try to go for that though. Maybe they felt it was too dangerous, and now he has his Radiance. 13 minutes Radiance, which is like as good as it gets. Like any timing around 11, 12, 13 is really great for the Alchemist, plus the armlet on top of that.
And No Tail is super farm. 9k, not shocking to see him this farm when he had so much room created for him on the Alchemist. He's doing really well.
And usually when Radiant side makes this move where they converge around the top tower of the Dire side, Dire should be able to get Roshan.
Mm-hmm.
But because they don't really have even the positioning to do that, they were trying to kill the Alchemist, so they couldn't even get anything as a trade-off for that, apart from the tower. So one for one tower, and OG dodged the gank, which Juggernaut was in danger of previously, so it was a good play for Miracle.
And now his Battle Fury is done. There it is. At 14 minutes, you have not only a Radiance Armlet Alk, but also a Battle Fury Jug for OG.
This is so, so bad for Empire right now. Like, there's no kills happening, but OG's just farming their way to victory.
Their movements just seem way better. They know what's coming. They know how to avoid the gank. You saw Miracle avoid that gank down bottom. And their Empire are forced to smoke up and go again. But again, you look at it, you see that there's only one person on the map. It's Miposhka. So maybe OG feels comfortable. This might be a bad fight for them for the first time. They will TP out No Tail. They're going to see that Moon is here. They're going to jump in. There's the Infest Bomb jumping out. The Iron Shell on top of Scandal doing more than enough damage. And Ramsey gets that kill. Malthus is going to find Fly. He's got Grave. He can TP if need be. They're going to clip some back statics for him. He cannot Grave himself anymore. Two quick kills, it's a double for Ramsey. They would have liked to get the No Tail.
It's again, it's not the heroes that OG worried about most, you know, the Jug and the Alchemist. The other heroes are okay, as long as we don't lose the Jug and the Alchemist, we are creating space. And you can see, like, Disruptor, like, whatever, I didn't even get to use my ultimate for a long time, so I'm just gonna drop this ultimate just to get this kill.
I mean, he's so poor too, he's just like, I need money, give me that gold. He has boots, stick, 250 gold.
This 6k, 7k net worth that OG has right now is just based on creeps and farming and getting the towers and just using the map much better. Empire is just under a lot of stress to push and try to get towers with their advantage right now.
Deny coming out, not there. Ramsey's open wounds walking up, but there's a lot of heroes for OG. Silence comes through. Ramsey's in trouble. He has no infest either. Omni Slash is ready. Malphus comes out to push them back, and Miposhka and the crew will be able to get away. They even drop the ward down after they leave. And there is a sentry there, though, so it should be countered. But still, yeah. They get the tower, and they don't lose anything, luckily. But again, No Tail just farms mid the entire time. He's like, whatever.
And here comes Moon. He's going to try and scout. He's looking for the lifesteal, which is still in the lane. He was expecting lifesteal.
He's going to find Miposhka again for like the fifth time this game. Dragon Tail is going to come out on crit, though, but... Black Hole? No, I thought it was used for a second, but no, he's just going to go ahead and TP out. Oh, he cancels the TP. They're waiting to try to turn this. He's got Black Hole ready. He's going to pop. There it is. Black Hole onto three. Can they get anything else with this? They got the water. The Omni-Slash vacuum coming in. Crit low. They've lost three. Will they lose more? No Tails in trouble. His armor will not save him. Miracle will try to TP out, but he won't make it. An Empire. Turn it into a five-man wipe. What a Black Hole for Miposhka. You've got to be... freaking kidding me, are you joking?
Man, that was like, he stopped his TP. I'm like, okay, I'm not gonna leave my buddy here to die, and he got such a big black hole because they thought he was actually already out, and they decided to go for the kill. Such a good play that by Miposhka.
That was insane.
That was what they needed. If that didn't happen, they were gonna be in such a bad position.
The
so...
game might have been over shortly thereafter, but... Yeah.
They have to be able to consolidate now. I think Roshan is the next important objective on the Dire side. Somehow they need to be able to secure the Roshan. Get more map control. They have pretty good vision now. This was placed in the smoke before. They had one ward in middle and one ward in the Radiant, the OG jungle.
Miposhka has a BKB, and there is nothing to stop Black Hole or anything through BKB. Oh, and Crit is going to get caught. Static Storm, they're going to get another one here. Malphus, the Eidolon damage is good. They're going to use the stick up. No Grave coming out. They don't have Fly there. They glimpse back. I think the Acid Spray, the Alchemist, excuse me, is back all the way to the base. He TP'd in to try to help his comrade out, but now they will more than likely lose this tier 1 on top of it. Not to mention, Ramses is looking for Fly mid, but Ramses is probably not going to find it.
Yep, they're going to be able to secure this tier 1 at bottom. And really good play from the Disruptor. They're saving the glimpse for the TPing hero. So overall, Empire, last 2 minutes, have gained a lot of ground in terms of net worth and map objectives. They got 2 towers. They got a team wipe. They got a pickup on support. And yep, like I mentioned, Roshan is still going to be their next important objective.
And they're getting all these items that they were not going to get before that team wipe even.
So they have a Shadow Blade on Skander now, so
exactly.
This is going to allow them to have much more opportunities to get a pickoff, transition into Roshan, get more objectives, or even get a tower.
They've got a lot to work with now, but still, OG, although the net worth graph says even, you still have an Alchemist who's farming very well. You now have the Jug who's still sitting on his Battle Fury. He's looking to get what I think is to be a Yasha as he has his Band of Elven skin. So we'll see how things transition. Scandal, oh, he was almost under that Observer Ward. He might have been, actually. He's going to go ahead and Shadow Blade
up. They see him. There's a sentry.
And there's a sentry. They have vision of him, so they know exactly where Scandal is. They're going to run all the way away. OG just back out as 5. As a team, they do not want any of what Empire cooking up, and so they get out in time.
Whew. So if you look at the vision once more, which is really important now, Empire have 3 good wards, one just expired in the OG jungle, and OG have wards only on the Empire jungle, so that was the place where OG would know if Empire is trying to do something funny.
Yes, the one place on the map for OG to be safe, and they were safe. But now, Miracle's in trouble, Infest out, look at that damage, he melts, but he dies to the neutral, you've got to be kidding me again. Empire, that would have been a huge kill. Sure, they get him down for 48 seconds, but they don't get the gold for it, you've got to be joking.
But a kill is a kill still, so they should be able to get the Roshan. 40 seconds, do they have a Blightstone on anyone?
I don't think so.
No Blightstone?
They have any armor reduction? I'm pretty sure they don't.
I don't think so, yeah. No Blightstone.
So this is going to take a bit longer than maybe they'd like it to.
It's still an Enigma with Eidolon, so it should still be fine in 30 seconds before Juggernaut respawns.
And everyone's just backing up. No-Tail's like, alright, I'm going to farm top. They're probably, you know, doing Rosher farming or something. We don't have vision anymore.
And
so
Afterlife is doing the right thing, going out to push the lanes, because Darkseid doesn't really offer too much. So he's making sure that he's giving vision and pressuring the lanes, and just trying to help his team transition into the next objective. So once you finish Roshan, lanes are pushed out, then you can move to your next objective. That's what Darkseers usually provide you. Because it's not like something that you talk about a lot when you pick Darkseer, but that's what the hero provides. It's easier for you to get objectives because you push the lanes all the time.
They get the Aegis. Afterlife. Newly minted Blink Dagger after that fight.
Mm-hmm.
And they're ready to go. They're going to find the courier too.
Oh, courier.
Later. What was on that courier?
Let's
find out. Ultimate Orb, Mantis Style, Recipe.
It's for the Juggernaut.
Yep. So Miracle will not have that for a bit. Now with the Elder Dragonform, Empire are like, all right, let's push up. We're feeling good. We don't want to take this game any later than we have to.
Yep, and they have the Grease right now, so he's not worried about crit silencing him up on the Darkseer. So after that, has his whole kit ready for his team fight, the Blink plus the Grease. So Empire just good to go with this timing. BKB, Black Hole, like you mentioned, nothing to stop it.
Yeah, that's the most important thing, one of the most important things. Sun's up onto Scandal, he does have Shadowblade, he's taking a lot of damage. Unstable Concoction will Shadowblade, but he's under the tower, so they have Vision still. The Guardian Grief will come out, and now it is time to back for Empire. They have to defend their tier 2 down bottom. Miracle might be in trouble, he's got Blade Fury, Ramses won't be able to chase him down and take him out, but still, they defend the tier 2, they put some pressure on the tier 3, they get the tier 2 mid as well. Empire pretty happy with that push, all things considered.
They didn't really deal too much damage though, it's like only 270 damage to the tier 3, and OG meanwhile was pushing and pressuring the other lanes. So all in all, I think it's much better for OG because they are behind right now, considering the circumstances. And they have to be able to prolong the game for...
Oh, Omni Slash, King Arc, and he saves a lot. He gets everyone. He jumps over to his teammates and actually keeps him off the Blade Fury, but the Glimpse back if they get Vision, and Afterlife will provide it. There it goes. No more Blade Fury, no more Omni Slash, and now he's in trouble. He'll try to bring down King Arc, but they get the Guardian Greaves off at just the last second. They get the Glimpse down as well, just to make sure he stays dead right there. He's dead for 53.
I think he should have tried to TP when he spinned to force the Black Hole at least. Because he was dead anyway. If he doesn't try to TP, he's going to get Glimpse. So I think he should have tried to TP and at least force the Black Hole, because they have to use the Black Hole to cancel his TP when he was spinning.
That's a tough play either way.
Yeah, but he was going to die.
He was
anyway.
Going to die.
There was
You're
no
right.
way he was going to live there.
And this is the perfect opportunity. 30 seconds without Miracle. They can just push in. They've got, again, we talked about it, BKB Black Hole. They've got everything they need. The Guardian Greaves are back off cooldown in 5 seconds.
Yeah.
And
imagine if they have used the Black Hole, that might actually deter Empire from doing this push. But nevertheless, right now, OG, they don't have buyback, and they're going to be able to do significant amount of damage.
Ooh, Empire Smoke behind the push of Empire's Scandal and Ramses. Force forward, Scandal might actually be in trouble. He has to pop his armlet here to stay alive. He's taking a lot of damage. The Silence will come out. They have Guardian Greaves. They're going to pop it here. He needs some sort of HP regen. He actually might die. The push coming out from the boulder smash, and he will get hit up by it, but he toggles perfectly to avoid any further damage and death.
Man, look at how hard is it to siege high ground nowadays. They dealt another, it was on 1300 HP, so they dealt another 500
They're
damage.
Getting there, slowly but surely.
Okay, they're getting there, but it shows you know how difficult it is to siege high ground right now, because with the armor, Tower's getting much more armor, and they have Alchemist and
spray,
Radiance,
right?
You know.
Crit can just boulder smash for days, and it's annoying, it's a nuisance for Empire, but it gives OG some room to work with. Yes, they're pinned back in their base, but No-Tail, he's got an Aghanim Scepter. Who's he going to gift it to? Is it going to be Crits, or is it going to be the Night Stalkers? I think it... Oh, there's a gem on the Night Stalkers, so I have to imagine it's going to be him.
It should be a Night Stalker, I think. Because at this stage, for you to be able to prolong the game, you need to be able to secure map control, and Vision is going to be allowing you to actually prolong the game. Because you have Vision, you understand where you should move and where you should split push.
Oh, that was
did he give it to someone else?
No, No-Tail got his Manta. We thought it was the Jug's Manta, it was No-Tail's Manta.
No,
so
yeah,
my apologies.
It is for... Oh, you're talking about Manta. No,
yeah, when the courier died earlier. Okay. Yeah, but we are right on the money when we talked about the Night Stalker, so yes.
He has a 4-star earlier, which is going to allow him to kite the Lifesteal. And now he has the Aghanims on top of that, so... This is really important for them to use this Vision to and prolong the game as long as... They possibly can until the Alchemist and and the Juggernaut get full slaughtered.
And Empire will start pushing in again. Some wards for the Radiant team, one on the cliff here to get Vision, but there is a smoke from Afterlife and Scandal. Actually, it's an Invis rune and a Shadow Blade, but Scandal will just go to work on the tower with the Shadow Blade. Draining down.
So basically the game plan for Empire is still the same, continuously pressure and wait for the next Roshan before they go again, which is quite a long while.
He still has the Aegis for like another 30 seconds or so.
I mean, they won't be able to do much with this Aegis anymore, so they have to wait for the next one before they want to siege again.
The lanes are too pushed out, I think, is the biggest issue, and yeah, there it is. The Aegis is gone. They just didn't have enough time also. It was a big issue.
Yeah. So basically, if you look at important items, maybe the BKB on Dragonite is the next important item they want to get. Lifestealer, he has 2k gold. The standard build will be getting an AC after this. That's very common nowadays.
Oh, they catch a Miracle. He gets caught. That's a static storm on top of that vacuum wall from Afterlife as well as King R. They get the kill. He's dead for 55. He has buyback, but he gets caught out. and it costs the position. They have an observer ward here. They might have just stayed behind in the tree line, smoked up or something, and they find that kill. Miracle just trying to farm, thinking that they had all left from Empire, but in fact it was a gank, so.
Yeah, this is why I mentioned vision is really important, because if they had vision around the area, then they would be able to identify the smoke gank or whatever. I mean, the gank coming in, not the smoke gank. So right now, they need to be able to move this Night Stalker around. You see, there's a lot of vision. If you look at the map, there's 3 wards from Empire in the OG side of the map. So Moon has to move around and remove those. It's really, really important that OG gets that done as soon as possible.
Yeah, so that Aghanim Scepter is level 1 darkness. He's only level 10. So Moon has been struggling so far this tournament in the games that we saw with Newbie.
I remember when I get gems on Batrider and other heroes, and when I'm playing with Mushi and I'm farming jungle, he's going to yell at me.
Dude, D-Ward, you just gotta do your job. BKB, Mufashka almost getting caught out by the unstable concoction, and still turn it towards Afterlife, and No-Tail wants him. Stun comes out with the boulder smash as well. He's low. He's got Guardian Greaves to keep him alive. Surge is ready. Good backing back into the high ground. He's gonna surge himself away. He's his Blink Dagger and 2. They will keep him alive somehow, just based off that vacuum alone. And the surge out with the Guardian Greaves. Well played from Afterlife to stay alive.
That was a really, really good vacuum, allowing him to save his own life. But right now, Nighttime looms. They popped the Night Stalker ultimate, so he managed to remove 2 wards. So there's only 1 ward, which is not so important, I would say, this ward compared to the other 2. Because this doesn't really provide Empire with too much information around the OG jungle.
And while this is all happening too, yeah, they dewarded and an OG in a good spot. No-Tail continues to farm. He's going to be a beast here pretty soon. He's going to have his Octarine Core coming out. He's going to be tanky. He'll have his armlet on top of that. It's going to be very difficult to bring him down and to deal with him in fights pretty soon, and his split push as well.
I wonder if he will consider getting an Aghanim's onto Juggernaut next. I think the Juggernaut Aghanim's is actually pretty strong.
You think so?
It's quite underrated. The cooldown is really good. You know?
Every person I... well...
70 second cooldown is really good.
Yeah, that's true. It's not about the jumps then, I guess, is it?
I mean, the jumps is also one thing, you know, but the 70 second cooldown sometimes can mean a lot. I've seen games where, because of the 70 second cooldown, the Juggernaut has a second ultimate, because it was a long fight, and it actually came into really, really good use. In some games, not every game, but...
I mean, if he gets farmed enough, I can assure you he will get an Aghanim Scepter and he will give it to Juggernaut if the game goes that late. But I'm wondering what he does build after that Octarine Core. We talked about AC for Empire. There's not... you could get AC, I think, for the Alchemist if you'd like to. I think it's not a bad item.
Yep, that's pretty good too. AC or Shiva sometimes. Mm-hmm. We see some players prefer the Shivas more because of the Octarine Core. You get a better cooldown on it. And you slow and allows your team to actually chase the target. But it was a really fast Roshan spawn. So it's actually better for Empire that Roshan spawns faster, but they have to be able to scout it out. Ooh. So a scan going down.
Good
from
scan.
Dire.
They had no vision over there either. That's just a scan randomly into the enemy jungle.
It's difficult for them to play now because it's nighttime. And Nightstalker has Aghanim, so he has a gem as well. So
they're going to go for a risky play. And they're going to smoke up and probably hit the Roche, I think. Or they might just go and
Did
wrap around
scout?
Without vision.
No, they didn't scout the Roche. So they actually have no idea Roche has already spawned. If they lose this fight, it would be bad for Empire.
Oh yeah, they a win here would be huge, but you could see they just take the tower and OG are going to back up with the exception of Crit. He has not been scouted, still flies a little bit close to Scandal. He doesn't see him though, the Shadowblade. The vision doesn't quite catch him and he'll actually be able to round the corner and stay alive. There's an Observer Ward that might have spotted out one of these 2 heroes. It looks like that's not the case.
Oh, Moon is the big kill, he has the gem. TP on cooldown.
Yeah, they're all going to get out. Empire can't find anything in OG back at the perfect time.
Yep. They should check the Roshan pretty soon, because that's the next important thing, like I mentioned. The next Roshan should be the Roshan that allows them to siege and get, preferably, if they can't get a side of Rex with the next Roshan, it's going to get tough for them. Because the Alchemist is actually getting into a stage where he's really, really hard to push against, and he's gonna allow the game to go for a very long time just by surviving. You know, if you can't gank the Alchemist is just gonna push out all your lanes, and you don't have vision because of Night Stalker, so it's very hard to catch him.
It was already hard to push against him in the first place, and now he has Octarine Core Manta style, so his illusions are all over the damn map. And like you talked about, the Night Stalker vision only adding to the woes of Empire. Not that this game is over, not that they're in any real danger just yet. They're still doing well. That's a Manta style for a lifesteal. A Ramses wants to avoid maybe the silence.
The silence.
And it helps with the Omni Slash too, which is definitely not bad. Okay.
I was actually thinking about maybe he was considering getting a BKB, because there's 2 silence from Night Stalker and Earth Spirit. Getting the Manta is also okay. Like you mentioned, it provides more against obviously the Omni Stash because you have the illusions and you have the move speed from Yasha.
He wants to go speedy. He has Surge to help him with that, but still, I mean, this is just, it's an interesting pickup. I don't know if it's the best one, but I like it to a certain extent. He's going to get the Aegis next, I think. Yep. Drop that TP scroll, and they have Aegis now. This is what you were talking about, waiting for the next Roche. So they... you have to make something happen here for your Empire, right?
Are they close to AC? No, what? Okay.
Midas from Mipashka. All right.
That is interesting.
That's playing for the late game. I don't know if you want to play for the late game if you're Mipashka.
I mean, there's nothing much that Anima can get right now to actually help. That actually might not be true, because you can actually get the Vlad too if you are really insisting in making sure that you want to use all your gold to help the push. So Vlad's is a good pickup here.
When we talked about what No-Till was going to get, I think we were right on the money with Shiva's or AC as a plate mail. So one of those two items.
I think AC might be slightly better because against Lifestealer.
Desolator, yeah. That's fair.
That might be slightly better than Shiva's is still great, but I would favor AC a little bit more.
Moon has made his home in the top lane. He's just been waiting for anybody to farm that wave. Empire, they're not going to bite. They have Ramzi's mid. Illusions will just run around and try to cut the creep wave.
Yeah, this is the right play, because for OG to prolong the game, you either want to get pick off and you want to remove the vision from the enemy team. So the Night Stalker, what he wants to do is either to stay with one of the cores, the Alchemist or the Juggernaut, or the second thing he wants to do is moving around the map to remove vision. So those are the two key things that he needs to make sure that he's constantly doing.
Well, Empire? Oh god. I just feel like it's so...
Yeah, they're playing for the late game, Travis.
we're gonna be here a while, aren't we?
Maybe for another one Roshan, I expect. Because with the next Roshan with Cheese, that should give Empire... If Empire gets it, that should give them enough advantage to be able to siege at least one Rex. I know I mentioned they have to be able to use this Aegis as well, but it seems like they are not very confident, and they don't have an AC of their own. So it's either they wait for the AC on Dragonite, but by that time happens, they might actually really run out of time on the Aegis. So, because he only has a Hyperstone and 1400 gold right now. He still
I don't think he'll finish it by the
time. He still needs the recipe and a chainmail, which is 2k gold.
Yeah, I don't think he's gonna get it yet. So, yeah, I mean, and the problem is that you just have to push out all the other lanes, and they've done an okay job of doing so. Like tops,
Daxia has been doing it a lot for his team, and he has a gem. So he's also moving around, trying to remove the vision. Like you can see that vision is really important for both teams right now, because the vision is going to allow them to plan ahead for the next move, to understand what they can do and what pickoffs they can get. Those are the things that is very, very, very crucial in late game situations. One pickoff might lead to the game just ending if you don't have buyback.
That's very true. For No-Till, he's got plenty of money. How much money does he currently have? 3,300. Everybody has a ton of money. The top four, it's like 3,300, 3,300, 3,200, 2,900.
Did he buy anything? No, I thought he was going to buy Aghanim's next, but Juggernaut is going to buy Skadi, so he's saving for buyback, plus the Skadi. So Alchemist has enough for buyback, obviously, but I'm thinking about what should he do next. Should he finish the plate mail with an AC or Shivas, or should he actually get an Aghanim's on someone like Earth Spirit or Juggernaut?
Earth Spirit might be a huge Aghanim's pickup.
Yeah, but the range though, like before I would... I wouldn't say it's the best now, but before I would not even hesitate a bit that you should give the Aghanim's to Earth Spirit.
Oh yeah.
But with the range nerf, I'm not sure if it's the best option anymore.
You like need a blink dagger or something.
Yeah, you need
now.
A blink on the Earth Spirit to make it useful.
So he would not be the best option. I mean,
if he has a blink, yes, I would say probably you could argue he's still good to give it to. But without a blink, probably you would give it to someone.
I think No-Till finishes up that plate mail for right now. I don't think he's really concerned about the Jug having better Omni Slash. Not yet, anyway. Oh, Shiva's. Okay. I thought it was going to be the AC, but the Shiva's instead.
It's still good, because with, like I mentioned, the Octarine reduction on the cooldown, and you're constantly slowing the enemies for your Juggernaut to catch up to kill. So it's... And it gives vision as well.
And the Juggernaut has Skadi as well, so it's going to make it even harder for Empire. We had the one big black hole that was an amazing team fight, and since then it has not been a very exciting or thrilling game. It's been a lot of cool movements, don't get me wrong. I like the way the game is going, but...
It's like a chess game, you know? You're figuring out what the enemy team is trying to do, and you want to focus on what you're trying to do as well, and at the same time understand what they're trying to do so you can actually catch them out before they actually do it. So it's a lot of moving around the map, and if the game goes into that stage, it's going to be easier for OG to understand what they should do, because they have Night Stalker, they have the Vision Hero, whereas Empire doesn't have the Vision Hero. They have Darkseer to push the lanes, but they do not have the vision to understand what they can do with when the lanes are pushed. So those are the things that are really, really important for both of the teams.
Empire has put some wards down, but it doesn't help the fact that Darkness is, you know, it just destroys
so
that vision.
AC is up, and how long more do we have? Oh no, AC is going to run out, so they won't be
It's just gone now. So and it's a 5.5 minute roast respawn from 5 minutes, so it's 10.5 minutes total roast respawn time, which is pretty close to max respawn duration.
So the last one was quick, this one is...
pretty long.
Pretty long.
We're going to be waiting for a little bit. Back to farming, maybe we'll see a smoke or something from either of these squads. I don't think anybody's willing to play too crazily yet.
Okay, they're going to find the vision. So, ward removed from OG Moon there.
We just watch Moon the entire game, he's just going to deward
everything.
He's
like the key hero. In this type of games, like the Beastmaster or the Night Stalker, the vision hero is the key hero, the Batrider, running around. Everyone else is just either staying behind, the support will be staying behind the carry, and then the carry will be pushing out the lanes. So the hero that's moving is the vision hero, or the hero that's trying to gank.
And it's not good, because Empire now have no wards down on the map, so it is completely dark, and talking about vision, that's not the best for Empire at this point, but...
Oh,
they're gonna find Poshka. He's gonna get Omni Slash with the BKB up, and he's gonna go down, dead for 64, with no BKB now. And that should turn into at least a tier 2 tower, maybe even a buyback if they want to force
they
it.
They don't have very good high ground defense. They have... if they defend that tower, they need to engage with Darkseer so that they can actually force a team fight. But they don't have an assist spray like OG when they're defending their high ground, so it's not so easy for them. But OG are still gonna proceed to back off. They are worried about Enigma having a buyback, which he does.
Yeah.
So Alchemist has his next item.
He bought another Ags. Oh, the courier! Look out. Alright.
I guess he's giving it to the Juggernaut?
Yep.
Yeah, he gave it to him.
I mean, it's really good. Like,
you called it. I was like surprised when you had mentioned that.
It's really good because of not only making you tankier, but the slash, obviously the slash bonus is also going to help you in doing more damage. But I think the underrated thing is the cooldown. The cooldown to me is the best thing. 70 seconds cooldown.
It might have been up already had he had the Aghanim Scepter earlier.
Disruptor has the Aghanim too.
Yes, that's something I saw, I did not point out yet though, but that is huge. I mean, a good Static Storm could win them the fight, because then you have the Vacuum Wall on top of it, you have the Black Hole to set things
those
up.
Those items are cool, Travis, but if a fight doesn't happen, it doesn't matter.
Exactly, that's the problem. It's all about split push this game. There's like, you have Empire who's like, alright, we got this all this team fight, we're gonna fight crazily, we're gonna get kills, and then OG's like, well, we'll see you guys. We have 3 kills, by the way, on our team. We're gonna see you guys in like 20 more minutes. We're gonna finish the game that way.
Now you can see and understand the idea behind why they actually choose to finish their draft with Night Stalker. So it actually is very obvious now what their plan is with the Night Stalker, just so when the game reaches to this type of situation, the Night Stalker is just providing so much. I know he's not getting any kills, he only got one kill and one assist the whole game, but he's actually influencing the game so much.
And that was my concern. I was like, okay, where's the damage? Doesn't matter, they're just splitting up the map, he's getting vision. He's dewarding, good stuff.
So important, like in Dota right now, heroes like Beastmaster and Night Stalker, like before, like maybe 2 or 3 years ago, vision hasn't been understood a lot more compared to now. So teams have not been focusing on picking heroes that provide vision. But nowadays, it's so evident that everyone understands that to be able to outplay and outmaneuver the enemy team, vision is so important. And so all these heroes have been so popular.
Beastmaster especially, but Night Stalker,
Bounty Hunter, whatever heroes that actually provide good vision, good information, good intel.
The vision won't help him this time as Mupashka does TP away. He gets out in time. They're gonna look for him, they're not gonna find him. There's a gem and an Aghanim Scepter for Night Stalker.
It's so frustrating. I don't know if you actually played the game like this against Night Stalker late game.
Mm-hmm.
It's so frustrating as the enemy
team. Oh, I know.
When you can't catch anyone, you don't have vision, it's dark everywhere. And it's so difficult to play against.
That's why I like playing him. It's just...
Oh, you like playing the Night Stalker, but you don't like playing
you
against
him. Yeah, you do not like playing against him. It's not fun.
It's definitely not fun. So Afterlife picks up a Hex, so he's hoping that this is going to allow them to get a pick off so they can actually transition into a push. But a scan from Radiant.
And Ramzes was the only one that walked that way. I still think they might have seen that smoke coming out from the Observer
there. They're moving
there
towards middle lane.
And they're going to look for No-Tail. He's maybe in trouble. They have to come back. They're looking for the black hole. They're going to find it. Can they get the damage done? Scandal comes in. You're going to be able to get that Hex off as well from Afterlife and get the job done. They'll bring down the Alchemist. Dominating spree for Scandal. Buyback is there because he is an Alchemist, so no big deal. But that's a big pickup, though, all things considered.
Can they force the buyback, though? That's the question. They have 70 seconds from now.
If Roshan was up, it would be great. But...
Roshan is in spawning in a minute. And if you look at Fly, he's pushing the top lane. Bottom lane's already all pushed up by the Juggernaut previously. So
God, and Afterlife's already gone back to defend. He has no bots.
Or Trevor?
No bots for Afterlife.
But are they not going to push?
No, he's gonna Iron Shell, and then Iron Shell top, and then come back mid, and they're going to wait like two creep waves or something.
But if
maybe.
If OG takes a team fight now, Alchemist buys back, it could be so dangerous for Empire.
It's a 4 versus 5 right now. This is very dangerous. There's the buyback coming out, and they're going to find Rhymes. He's going to get the Rage off, and he might actually get away. Miracle not initiating, doesn't have a Blink Dagger, can't get close enough to find an Omni Slash, and they will get out. That was super dangerous from Empire, but boy, does it pay off.
Oh my god, they didn't land the stun, otherwise I think it could have been so bad for Empire. Because OG knows that Darkseer cannot come to the fight, he doesn't have a boost of travel. That's why I was surprised that they actually made that move, because it was so risky.
Oh, what a scan, are you kidding me? Oh my god, there's no ward there.
Man,
but
teams have been getting better at using scans from this game, I can tell.
They know that they're coming. Empire have a feeling, they need to get together. There is an Observer Ward here on the high ground that will scout out what Empire is doing with their maneuvers, but Empire are together now.
Well, OG's gonna be able to take the Roshan.
No, Empire do something about this.
They don't have Black Hole though.
Darkness has been popped, no Black Hole like you talked about, down for 65. They should know that they're in Roshan. And
the vision is good enough to for OG to be able to successfully...
Can you give this away? If you're Empire?
They are very scared of taking a fight here because of Night Stalker. Like, they have the vision, so they are going to be able to use the information to decide when to take a better team fight than you. So if you're Empire, you're very worried about that. So they decided that it's not worth contesting the Roshan because it's very likely they lose the fight. But like you were talking about, is it the right choice? I'm not sure, because in their position, they even though it's hard, they have to do it. Because the longer the game goes, it's better for OG.
Oh yeah, for sure. The late game scaling carries of the Alchemist and the Juggernaut, not to mention the Night Stalker getting a bit tankier and doing more damage.
He's buying an AC. Siri has it? He has an AC.
Who, the...
To Alk.
Alk?
He just got an AC, so he sold his...
He has no slot for it, though.
He sold his Armlet.
Oh, that's interesting. Not the worst thing. Yep. I think that's a smart play.
Armor for your team, you know, can't go wrong with that. And they still don't have a Vlad's, though. Vlad's is still pretty nice for the Juggernaut.
I think that's
the
Night Stalker item.
Yeah.
He should build that next. He has enough money for an hour just about, I think.
He might be saving for buyback first.
Yeah, so that's probably the more likely thing. He has enough money for it now, but yeah, he's probably saving for buyback. Alright, well.
Are we going to see refreshes on Darkseer and Enigma? I mean, at this rate...
I mean, we're going to see a pretty long game, I feel like. We talked about it earlier. We're like, okay, well, we're in for the long haul. You said something, and we might be heading down that direction. We saw a 90-minute game earlier. I don't think that this game will go that long. There's no tinker in the game. You know, there's nothing too crazy.
But you have Alchemist. So Alchemist itself, I mean, some games with Alchemist, it goes, you know, it ends fast because you get crushed a lot in the early game or whatnot.
Right.
But this type of games with Alchemist, with the offering call, you're gonna make the
new Naga Siren, dude.
Yeah, he's like the Naga Siren. It's either you get crushed very badly early game or the game goes super long.
There are ways, like, I think a lot of people feel like when you're playing against a Naga or an Alk that's this farmed or this ahead or is doing well, a lot of people feel like, oh, okay, well, we can deal with this now, but that's not necessarily true. I've seen games where teams have come back from this kind of deficit against an Alk or a Naga Siren.
Oh, here we go.
Empire have run into a lot of heroes. Ramses as well. No Blink Dagger, though, to initiate. Afterlife's a little bit too late to the party. Can't find what he's looking for with a vacuum and wall. And so OG will move away together. Moon sitting on the high ground with his Blink Dagger. Afterlife will spot him out, though. This is dangerous. He's going to blink down to the low ground for Moon. He'll get out. And that's going to be the end of the engagement. So that's what this game has really been all about. It's a lot of it, I guess you call it playing footsies with each other and just tiptoeing around. And just...
A chess game, like I would say.
Yeah, exactly. It's a chess game at this point. But OG, they might be sick of it being a chess game. They are looking to counter-engage. They're going to try to find Scandal. He does pop up the Shadow Blade, but Moon has the Gem of True Sight, not to mention the Great Vision coming out from Darkness and the Aghanim Scepter. However, they won't find anything as Empire are back in the base. You can see the Illusion's going to go right to work on the Tier 3. Miracle will pop his Mantra. They have creeps in the base. Miracle gets stunned up. Static Storm coming out. Now they're looking for a Black Hole. He's going to use his solo onto Miracle. He's in trouble. He's got cheese. They get the Grave off. Miracle will pop the cheese. Maybe no, he gets X'd up. Can he stay alive for the last second? He can't get the cheese off. And they've lost two. He's got buyback, but does he have boots of travel? He does. Will he come back into the fray is the question. Scandal looking for more. No-Tail about to get caught out. He stuns the wrong one. Great play from No-Tail. Microing his Illusion. It's now he's gonna get caught with the mouses. Ramsey's looking for an open wound. They're gonna get off a great magnetized crit onto four. Vacuum wall is there. They get the Aegis down and crit now in trouble. They're tanking through all this damage. Ramsey's is full health. Bike back coming into the junk. Can he TP in time? No tail. Gets stunned up. Can he get brought down? It's a double kill for him. He's doing so much work with his radiance, but Ramsey's is able to chew through him. And here comes Miracle, not done yet. Rage is up and available for the Lifestealer. Kinetic Field, Omni Slash will go, and it's an Aghanim's Omni Slash. The Rage will not help him, and Miracle buys back just to get that kill. He might get two King R. Glimpse back, Blade Fury is there. Miracle picks up a double after the buyback. What a fight. Holy, what the hell just happened?
That was such a good initiation from the Enigma, the Disruptor. Like, making sure that they get to both the important heroes in the Black Hole and in the Static Storm, and because of the Aghanim's, he can't pop his cheese earlier. And the Grave was actually slightly a bit too early, otherwise I think Juggernaut would have been able to pop his cheese, even though it was already a really good Grave. That was very, very close to being disastrous, because I think if they got the Grave at the perfect time, he pops his cheese, didn't have to use the buyback, and he gets his Omni Slash off, and he had Arcane Rune at that time, so
yes.
The Omni Slash would have been like 40 seconds cooldown, so he had a really good chance of popping two Omni Slashes in one.
And that fight was pretty long, yeah.
That was a very long fight.
I mean, he was literally like dead for 20 seconds, then he bought back and TP'd in, so that just kind of gives you the indication that was a long fight. By the way, No-Tail did a lot of damage, despite being disabled for pretty much the majority of that engagement.
Radiance, yeah. Acid Spray.
Yeah, pretty good. Rating Assassin's Spray, Shiva's was used, I think, at one point. Ramses was forced to buy back, so buyback growth from both Ramses and Miracle. That puts this game into even more of an awkward position, and on top of that, the Jug still has his cheese. Yes, he died, but he still has cheese. So
he's gonna try and get a solo pick up here on Miposhka. Oop! Oop!
Omni Slash. Oh no, what a bounce! No! Miposhka's okay. Gonna blink into the tree line and TP away, and Miracle's
seconds.
Like, what?
You 70
gotta
seconds
kidding.
Cooldown, whatever, you know? No luck, but he tried.
Did he have buyback? Oh yeah, he definitely had buyback. Yeah, he had 5,000.
I mean, going back to the point where you brought up previously, before the fight started, where you're talking about if you're Empire, what you want to do, what you're gonna do if the game goes late, you have to rely on your team fight, get your refreshers. I think that's the best way of them approaching the late game. Refresher on Darkseer, refresher on Enigma, and even the Disruptor, if you can actually get the refresher on Disruptor, because he has the Aghanim. So all those ultimates are really, really powerful, and percentage base, pure damage, midnight pulse, and Darkseer's ultimate obviously gets better when you have more items on the enemy team.
This is getting to an interesting spot for sure. Again,
I know it might seem like OG has the late game, but the team fight is still on Empire's favor.
I think it just comes down to movement and what we've been talking about, vision, for a long time.
Yeah, they can use the vision and speed push and never have to take a direct fight. That's what they can do.
That fight looks like it, because the Grave was just a little bit too early, it looked like Empire was going to clean house there after they killed Miracle, but that buyback was pretty ridiculous in more ways than one, in a good way too. He got two kills out of it, forced the buyback from Ramses.
So they have a Monkey King bar on the lifesteal right now on Ramses. He has 4 minutes cooldown on his buyback, and so I think the Juggernaut has about the same too.
Yeah,
no, Juggernaut's 340. So next Roshan is gonna be. Did they change the timer on the Roshan?
Well, we don't know when the next when it's actually coming up. We only know that it's the timer will show itself in a minute, or so, about a minute.
So Enigma is actually not going for a refresher. Is he going for Octarine Core?
I wouldn't put it past him. Cooldown reduction on your ultimate is pretty good.
Nah. That
Bloodstone
is
something Puppy used to do all the time.
That can't be the most optimal option. I don't think this is the most optimal. Like, you don't need to lower your cooldown. You just need to use it twice for refresher on your Black Hole. I mean, the cooldown reduction on Midnight Pulse, probably the most valuable, but nah. I still think refresher.
Well, he's got 100 before he buys it. I'm sure he's
gonna refresher is definitely the best play. I don't think this is the best.
Well, he's not getting refresher. It's either a Bloodstone or an Octarine.
Yeah, I don't think this is the best play.
One of the two.
Regardless of what he gets.
Moon is gonna come in with that darkness, and they're hunting. They're looking towards the enemy side of the map for now. But Crit and Miracle have they see Scandal. He Shadow Blades away, and they should know that everyone is here right now. And so this is an awkward engagement. OG don't want to take just yet. They are gonna bots in. And that's going to be the Darkseer with bots now. They're looking for an initiation. No, that's an illusion, Miposhka. You've made a huge mistake. It's time to back. It's time to leave if you are Empire. Get out right now, and they will not be able to get Miposhka. He's going to get stunned up. Void comes out on the other side. Malphus is going to come through. They're going to clear out these illusions. Omni Slash. Not there yet. Miracle finally pops it off and Meepossum gets blown up, but that's only one kill out of that. They get the static storm, but he gets forced out of it. But No-Tail's still in trouble. Back into it, gets revved up and will stay alive. Miracle's trying to clean house right now. The Battle Fury cleaving through everyone, but No-Tail will finally go down. They get the Hex off into Miracle. He's in trouble, getting bashed up. Can they bring him down? Yes, the Breathe Fire from Skinner will do the job. Moon hightailing it out of there, realizing this fight has turned sour very quickly. Open Woods comes out, the Bash is there as well. They get a double kill for Ramses, and suddenly Empire turn the tides after a disastrous black hole, one of the worst that you could possibly have. It doesn't matter. It does not matter.
They wasted a black hole, and they wasted a BKB and Dragonite, and somehow they were still successful in winning that team fight. They managed to take out the Earth Spirit. He didn't get his ultimate off, and they only have a buyback from Alchemist. So there's only three heroes here. Can they defend?
This is gonna be tough. There's no buyback coming out for the Juggernaut. They get the Hex off into No-Tail. He's gonna stun himself too. They missed the vacuum though. He's got his chemical rage still going. He has the Octarine for as well, the ratings, but he's getting bashed up like crazy. They get the Grave off in time. Is it going to be enough? They have another Breeze Fire in 2 seconds. They get off the Magnetize, and Empire might just back up. Infest out won't do enough damage to bring No-Tail down. Scandal will back away. Ramses, he really wants this. Pops the rage, going with the Open Wounds now into Fly. Bashed up, no Grave for him. He just used it on his comrade, No-Tail. Charging up the stun again. Looking for the bash, can't get it with the rolling boulder. No-Tail's gonna get stunned up again, hexed up as soon as he gets the unstable concoction. He's looking for it, and he's dead for 113 seconds, and Empire are going to work at the tier 3 tower. They even dropped the wall for that kill, they didn't even need it. Meepossum's back and he's got his ultimate in 49 seconds. Moon is here, no jug for 34, buyback's not there for another 29 seconds, so they'll have to wait that 30 seconds to be able to get in, and they will lose their full set of racks down bottom and maybe more winter. Not done yet. Vacuum back into Fly, hexed up, but they might just turn their attention back towards the tier 3 tower. They're going to get another full set of racks, and they cannot deal with this. They might even get a third full set of racks for Empire and take this first game, Winter.
Oh my god, what a game by Empire after that disastrous early game.
Crit's not done yet, but he is taking some MKB hits.
He's done now. He's definitely done now.
That is going to be it, probably. Still no out for 68. Glimpse back in. Fly is able to force staff through and he gets the Grave off in time, but Moon's the one that's hexed up. Vacuum in onto 3. Fly about to go down. Midnight Pulse won't chunk him down enough, but it'll get him low that he has to stay in the well. Now with 3 sets of racks, they've corralled them into the base. Empire, all they need to do is, first of all, they can just back up or they can start pressuring these tier 4 towers. There's still no Alchemist for 50 seconds. They pretty much just won at this point, Winter.
Yeah. Man, Meepossum, despite having the most disastrous early game, but I think he's the MVP for that.
Static Storm, Black Hole, he refreshed to Miracle. He refreshed for another Omni Slash, but they make sure to bring him down. No buyback, he's dead for 96, and GG is called. What a first game in this best of three series. That was an awesome game. That was a lot of fun.
Yeah, there was a lot of situations in the game where it looked like it was really good for OG, but Empire managed to outplay them in especially the first team fight at the top Dire Jungle, where Enigma was TPing out. OG was like, okay, we can't kill this guy, just ignore him, we'll kill his team. And then he cancels his TP, and he comes back for that five-man.
It was like three-man black hole into a five-man vacuum.
Oh my